join me in the pledge of the flag?
Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Into the Christian flag. Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands, one Savior, crucified, risen, and coming again, with life and liberty for all who believe.
Into the Bible. Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will hide its words in my heart that I might not sin against God.
Will you pray with me? Dear God, thank you for our mothers and that we go to celebrate them on Sunday. And I hope that everyone finishes strong and that fifth grade has a great trip.
This is our last chapel for this year, which is just crazy to me that we're already here. And I'm grateful. We are going to enjoy both of our chapel teams that have led us this year. And so I want us to worship together. I want us to enjoy this time together. And more than anything, to focus our hearts on the Lord and focus on worshiping Him, giving Him all the glory for the great things He has done this year. So let's worship. And before we actually get into the worship part, we're going to warm up with one of our favorites. We're going to do Brother Friend. And we'll move around and change partners a couple times, but start with a partner. You don't leave anybody out. If you need a group of three, you can do three. But let's do the motions really quick. You're my brother. You high ten. You're my friend. Shake a hand. You're my beginning. Now point behind you and my end. You're all around me. When the world just turns and walks away, give them a hand. You're my sunshine on a cloudy day. You're my rain that washed my blues away. Now point into your neighbor's hand and they'll point into yours. I can always count on you because you're my brother or girl, sister. You're my friend. And you shake a hand and then you find a new partner. All right, here we go.
You're my brother, you're my friend, you're my beginning and my end.
focus in and be grateful to the Lord and lift our voices to Him.
Can't escape disappointment. Can't avoid the delay. I don't have to make you lay down and defeat in the place that I stay. Gonna rise to the moment. Gonna speak to the waves. Gonna push back the doubt that keeps dragging me down when I can't find a way. Don't need to see.
Jesus is our promised land and life with Him forever. So let's enjoy this song together.
To Cain and Spirit High.
You may be seated.
Naaman is healed. 2 Kings 5. Over the years, the country of Syria had invaded Israel many times. When they invaded, the Syrian army would steal the Israelites' food and money. Sometimes they would even kidnap people from Israel and force them to work as slaves in Syria. Naaman was a great warrior in the land of Syria. He was highly respected by everyone who knew him, but he had a big problem. Naaman had a skin disease that could not be cured, leprosy. Naaman also had many servants. One of his servant girls was kidnapped from Israel. She knew all about God and the prophet Elisha. Instead of being angry about being kidnapped, the servant girl chose to be kind. She told Naaman about God and the prophet Elisha. She knew God had the power to heal Naaman's skin disease. The servant girl said, "You should go to Israel. Elisha lives there. He knows God. God will give him the power to heal you." Now, Naaman had a choice. He could choose to ignore the girl, or he could choose to listen. Naaman chose to listen. He packed up all his things and headed to Israel, which is a very, very long way away from Syria. But when Naaman arrived at Elisha's house, he arrived in style. He had brought a lot of money and many gifts for Elisha. But when Naaman knocked on Elisha's door, Elisha did not even greet Naaman. Instead, Elisha's servant Gehazi came to the door. Naaman was a little insulted. After all, he was a famous army commander in Syria. He was a leader, and he expected people to treat him differently than the way they treated normal people. Still, he had come all this way, so he decided to listen to Elisha's instructions. Gehazi told Naaman Elisha's instructions. Go and wash yourself 7 times in the Jordan River. Then your skin will be restored and you'll be healed of your leprosy. But Naaman became angry and stalked away. I thought he would certainly come out to meet me, he said. I expected him to wave his hand over the leprosy and call on the name of the Lord his God to heal me. Aren't the rivers of Damascus better than any of the rivers in Israel? Why shouldn't I wash in them and be healed? So Naaman turned and went away in rage. Before he left, Naaman's servants stopped him. They told him to listen to Elisha's instructions and obey them. Now, Naaman had another choice. He could choose to stay angry, or he could choose to listen. Naaman chose to listen. Naaman went to the river and washed 7 times.
Can y'all guys count to 7 with me?
Focus on you. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, you are dismissed quietly back to bed.